So hello students, today we back with, in the previous one we have studied the generation of amplitude modulation, and today we'll start with the detection of the linear modulation or amplitude modulation. The first and the most basic of this demodulation of linear modulation is the envelope detector, first process. So we'll basically study three processes, that is envelope detector, there is synchronous detection method, and due to the error or limitations of this synchronous detection, we'll come to Costa's receiver. So first, envelope detection. It is a known factor that a diode operating in a linear region of its VI characteristic can extract the envelope of an AM wave. So this type of detection is known as the envelope detector. In the circuit, you can see here, this circuit. The first, you can see there is a tuned transformer is there. It will just pass whatever the frequency received here at the receiver, that is amplitude modulated, or it will pass to the secondary side. Now, there is a diode. In this circuit, diode D operates as a half-wave rectifier. So if this is half-wave rectifier, it will pass the half cycle, that is the positive cycle. You can see the AM input is like this. So after diode, the output will be like this. So the remaining portion in the negative cycle will be eliminated, and the positive cycles will all pass through the diode. So it is basically acting as a half-wave rectifier. Then you can see in the circuit there is RC filter is there, that is nothing but a filter. So you know the basic property of capacitor, that is it charges and discharges according to the input given to it. So you see the output of the diode is applied to the capacitor. So first it will start charging from zero to this peak, and then it will again discharge and again pick this one and got the charge, again discharge and got charge for the next week, and again discharge and got the peak again. So it will carry on like this, and it will give me almost a sine wave output. This is my message signal output detected from the amplitude modulated wave. So this is how the very first detector, that is envelope detector, works. It is having a time constant tau equals to R into C. If the value of the capacitor C is very, very high, it will be a more smooth sine wave to detect, and the process will be repeated until all the message signal is retrieved. So this is my very basic part, that is envelope detector. Now I'm coming to synchronous detection method. As we all know, the DSB-SC signal gives me an expression like this. This is the block diagram of the synchronous detection method. So XT into cos omega CT, where XT is the message signal and omega C is the carrier signal. So receiving antenna is receiving the DSB-SC signal, and a locally generated carrier, that is twice cos omega CT, is applied to the multiplier input, having an amplitude of 2 and with same carrier frequency, with same frequency and phase that was applied in your transmitting side. That is why it is synchronous detection. So this is applied to multiplier. So if I multiply 2 cos omega CT and XT cos omega CT, the output will be 2 XT cos square omega CT. And it is basically applying to a low pass filter. Now I will derive the expression ET equals to 2 XT cos square omega CT. So it is giving me XT into 2 cos square omega CT. So 2 cos square theta is 1 plus cos twice theta, that is 1 plus cos twice omega CT. So if I multiply this, it will give me XT plus XT cos twice omega CT. So if I am applying this signal to a low pass filter, XT is low frequency, that is consists of message signal, and there is a high frequency component, that is twice cos omega CT. So this second term will fully rejected by the low pass filter, and my message signal XT will be retrieved at the output of the synchronous detection method. Okay, so now I'm moving forward. You can see in the frequency domain, XT plus XT cos twice omega CT. So if I put the value of XT, that is Vm cos omega MT, where Vm is the amplitude of the message and omega M is the frequency of the message signal. So it will give me the expression like this. Now cos A into cos B will give me half cos A plus B into cos A minus B. So upper side component, lower side component and the message signal component. So in frequency domain, we will have a waveform. Sorry, in the frequency domain, we have the spectrum like this, that is X0, half X0 and another half X0 amplitude. And the frequency will be like this from the expressions. Okay, now I'm coming to some limitations of this synchronous detection method. In synchronous detection method, there are some limitations that the frequency and phase of the locally generated carrier local oscillator should be matched perfectly with the transmitted carrier signal. But in case, suppose in the locally generated carrier, there is a frequency error and phase error. These are del omega and phi respectively. Del omega is your frequency error and phi is the phase error. So my multiplication result before the low pass filter will be like this. Not this time, it will not be 2xt cos square omega ct. It will be xt cos omega ct into twice cos omega c plus del omega t plus phi. So again, 2 cos a cos b, it will give me cos a plus b plus cos a minus b. So this is my cos a plus b. Omega c plus omega c is twice cos omega c plus del omega t. This is an error, not t will not be present here. Plus phi. And cos omega a minus b will be like this. Cos omega c will be cancelled. So after low pass filter, this portion is rejected and this portion is passed through the low pass filter and it will be my output. So you can see in the output there is a frequency and phase error is having its effect. So the message signal is perfectly not received. There is attenuated or distortion. So there may 4 cases be occur. There is no error, omega, del omega is 0, phi is 0, so my output will be xt because cos 0 will be 1. Now, if del omega is 0, that is no frequency error, but phase error is there, so it will give me xt cos phi, so output will have phase mismatch. If the frequency mismatch was there in the local oscillator generated carrier, then the output will have frequency mismatch. If both occurs, then both mismatch will be there, so attenuated or distorted output we will receive. In order to eliminate this disadvantage, we move forward to Coaster's receiver. This is my DSBSC signal. It is applied at the input of the Coaster's receiver and it is passed through 2 product modulator, that is product modulator 1 and another is my product modulator 2. Now you can see the locally generated carrier is coming from here through a VCO. Voltage control oscillator and it is going to this. So there is a frequency and phase error, you can see cos omega ct plus phi, and it is getting a 90 degree phase shift to go to the product modulator. So it will pass sin omega ct plus phi. My upper portion is known as I channel. Upper portion is known as I channel and lower portion is known as Q channel. So at the low pass filter, it is such design is that xt cos omega ct into cos omega ct plus phi. If we multiply this, it will give 2 components, that is cos 2 omega ct plus phi and another is cos phi only. That is because cos a plus b will be 2 cos omega ct plus phi and cos a minus b, this omega ct and this omega ct will be eliminated, only cos phi will be present. So it will give me a half cos phi signal. And again in the Q channel, it will give me half xt sin phi. Both the signal are passed through phase discrimination. In phase discrimination, what is my operation? My operation will be like this, root over I square plus Q square. So from here, if we take half X square T common, it will give me cos square phi plus sin square phi, which is obviously 1. So inside root, it will only present x²t. So inside root x²t, so output will be xt. That's how message signal is retrieved from Costa's receiver. So thank you. These three receivers we will study today. And this was all for today. Thank you.